Hi guys, it's me Karen. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to do a page in the Coleridge Wild 4 by Emmanuel Colin. I'm going to do this page here. I've got out a bunch of distress ink and we're going to do some inking on the page. See how that works. We've got gathered twigs, vintage photo, which are two colors I use a lot. Brushed corduroy, wild honey, and a tea dye, which I use occasionally with all the browns. So we're gonna ink in a couple of colors in here and maybe do our hair in the same color and maybe tip in some of these little feathers up here. I'm gonna be using the, and these are called the mini detail blending tools from Ranger. I'll try to leave a link down below. They're sometimes hard to find. They have the same kind of foam tip as the big tools do, but they're smaller. They're put on dowel sticks. They're not the best thing, but they work for what I'm going to use them for. So we're going to start off with I think some of the wild honey first and see how we get along here. Just gonna dip that in. Find a little piece of paper just so I can tap it off so I don't have too much of a problem here. And we're just going to apply some in to the lighter areas of this little kitty cat. So how is everybody doing today? I hope you're all well. Had a wonderful weekend. I have to excuse my fingernails, but I'm not going to redo them quite yet. I'm doing a bunch of yard work outside and thought I'd come in and do a little picture. And then I'm going back out, deadheading all the rhododendrons and pulling out some other weeds and stuff, and don't want to paint them all up and have them all messed up in a real quick minute. We're gonna put some of this in her hair too. Some like highlights here and her braid. And let's pick a feather about this one. And maybe that one there. Okay. All right. Got some nice highlighted areas there. Then we're going to go in with a darker color. And we'll go in with brushed corduroy. Other side here. In the darker areas. I am tilting it so I'm kind of just using the corner of that to draw it up. Get our spots in here, we can tap those. on some of these dots back here. And then just kind of darken this area. And we'll darken up in her hair up here. And darken that feather a little. There we go. Next color. That's one I didn't get out. Thought I did, but I'll have to get it out later. We'll go with the vintage photo. It's kind of a redder color. Okay, little gathered twigs. It's going to be a little deeper, softer brown. Well, we could put coloring there. Let's see if we can't erase that a little bit. I went out of the line there. You can get it if it's wet. Okay, we will see if we can't find the darker color I'm looking for. Maybe it's out already, I don't know. Sometimes I don't put my ink away, and I didn't, so here we go. Walnut stain. That's almost black. So we'll see which one is. Probably this one here. We're just going to go in the darkest areas here with this. Almost the black parts, like his nose, that little line I want to darken right there, up here by his eye. Maybe a little eyebrow action going up here. His ear. Tip. Not too much of that out there. We can have a little fluff, but not too much. Okay, in her braid here, we're going to go just where it's the darkest and put some of that in there. Underneath the braid here. Pull it down. Holding that at a very sharp angle and only using the wood and that little teeny tiny piece to get some of that going up in the hair. Do that up here in this feather too and darken this side. Okay, anything else I can see here that I want to darken? Okay, we're going to get out, I wonder if I could do her, I don't think I have a light enough color to do her face in ink. Really don't. I can do her in, Copics though, so. We'll get out a light Copic. This is 000. I don't want that point. We'll pull that into her hair. It will pick up some of that ink too, so we want to be a little careful. The lightest color I have. We're going to have to let this dry, so. Okay. Okay. That'll be interesting. We can pull in some of this dark. Eighteen copper. The other one is 15 dark suntan. Okay, someone at the door. Excuse me for a minute. Okay, we're going to go with the E11. What is this one called? Barely Beige. And we're just going to go in here and make sure those ink lines or Copic lines I put in here don't look too blotchy. Close that one up. And we have the E00. All right, that's as much as I'm going to do with the ink and stuff, and I will get out some pencils. Okay, we got out some pencils. They're the Polychromos dark brown black shades. So we're going to go in with black first, and we're going to kind of darken up some of these little spots on our little kitty cat. Kind of make his ear look a little bit more like an ear. A little more like a cat. And then darken up some of these back here too. Bring in a little ivory. It's pun intended, it's a little teeny ivory. And it got a little darker than I intended. But we'll cover that up with a little bit of, and this is burnt sienna. And keep layering in little lines and different colors. Bring in dark sepia. Let's see what we bring in now. We've got burnt umber. Thank you. And we have walnut brown. Hold on just a moment. Okay, let's just add a little bit of this in here to darken up those braids just a little bit, and then underneath the braid on two sides. I don't want to do it in the middle. I just want to do it on the edges over here. Darken that side up. Just a little bit up here. And we'll bring that around. Tiny bit is a shadow there. Okay, we're going to need to get out light flesh here. Add some color in here. And add a tiny bit of a pinky tone to that. So we're going to go in with some cinnamon. Okay, then we will bring in a white, probably a Prisma, just to blend that up just a bit more, if I can find it. Sometimes I have problems finding stuff on my desk, just because I make a mess on my desk. There we go. Make sure there is no color on the tip of that, because we do not want to add in an extra color that we don't have here. And we're just going to kind of blend it around a little bit and soften it up. A little bit of gray that's being picked up there. I've got a shoulder here, but it's not being seen very well. Can't pick up some of that gray out of there with the eraser. don't know if it will take it out or not because it's on the paper. But I did okay. Back in with the light flash. Just add it in there to get a little more pink. Certain areas I want to stand out a little bit more. Okay, we're going to put a little, what is this, dark flesh here on her lips. Just kind of a hint of a lip there. Blended in with the light flesh. And let's see, we'll add some of that dark flesh up here. Some of the white. Just gonna have a little bit of a where's the cinnamon? Rounder face here. If she's young. Okay, now let's see, what color is Kitty Cat's eye? I think it's a cheetah, so I'm going to look up cheetah real quick and see what color their eyes are. I think they're kind of a golden color. Cheetah. One picture would do. Yeah, they're kind of a gold color, so... pull out these. We have a Naples, a dark Naples ochre, yellow ochre, and brown ochre, and we're going to do that in their eyes. So that is a dark Naples ochre. We're going to do it in both of their eyes so they match. This is the light yellow ochre. And then the dark, well, the brown ochre. It's going to be dark because it's brown. Just a little bit on that side. So up here, she's got this big line here. I'm not dealing with it right now. I need to see where the blending goes, so. Do that and then mess with that other part later. I want her eye just a touch darker, so I'm going to bring in the burnt sienna up here. get little on his right there. Okay, she needs a pupil. Which I'm going to put in. Sorry, I want that gray line gone a little bit more. I'm having a problem with that one. Bring in a whole blend white and whiten up this little dude a little bit here and give him some extra hair. A little blue here in her eye. A little tiny touch in his, not much. You can barely see that part. I'll try this color in there. I can make sure there's no other color in there. It just picks up the gray. Yep. And maybe I'll have to stretch that out a little bit. And we'll get just a little bit more color on here, and then we'll do the leaves, and hopefully I have enough power on my camera. Didn't think about that. I'm gonna add a little freckles in here and pull up some of that color. To purposely make that look a little more blotchy. And then we'll bring in some extra freckles in this area since I can't get the gray out. So we will take our cinnamon. Let's see. It's not going to be dark enough. I don't want them too dark. Don't want them red. Bring in the burnt sienna. Okay, then we'll add just a touch of some of this color on her. What do we use? We'll start in with the wild honey and just lay it in there. Let's see if we can find the ink pad that I had right under her eye. And then just a little bit of a darker color. Vintage photo. have something we can drag down just a little bit further. And that would be gathered twigs. A little darker. We have some feathers to do. Since we have a little bit of blue in their faces there, I'm gonna do one of these in blue. Just real lightly. I think there's a polka dotted something in here. I don't know where that one came from, but that's a feather too. Do this one. We'll go in with some ivory on that. Okay, then we'll do just take one of these, start that, and that was wild honey. And we'll throw a little tea dye in there. Why not? I brought it up and I haven't used it yet. Just a little bit of burnt sienna in here. We'll throw some dark flesh into one of these. Add some pink into it, some cinnamon. night fish. This is dark fish. Just wanted a little bit more pink in that. Put a little black around the eye here. And there, and I think we're just about done. I just have to put white in the pupils. I can get the cap off. So. Just let that dry and then add a little more darkness in there. I'm going to do the whiskers. I'm could do some of that up in the feathers too. I am running out of battery though. Make that one extra fluffy. Okay, and then I'm just gonna darken a little bit of that as an eyebrow coming up. Add a little more spots in here. Bit of brown ochre in this area here. Darker underneath, and then we will be done. Hopefully. If nothing else, I will just take a picture of it at the end of the video and you'll see what it looks like. Just want to darken that up a little bit there. Need to be that fluffy. Yep, I'm gonna quit playing with it now. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope you had fun. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope to see you in another video. Just a little more color there. I'll take a picture of it and post it at the end of the video. I hope you have a wonderful day. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section down below. I'm just going to darken those little tips down here. And I'll get to them as soon as I can, the questions. And I'll try to leave. I said I had a link for something and I just don't remember what it was. All these tools. And I'll leave that down below too, along with all the pencils I used. So I hope you all have a wonderful day. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care, everyone. Bye now.